So these are blue wood asters, unlike the white wood asters which are common and grow in the shade. These are just a slight off-white, slightly blue, some bluer than others, and another late, very late blooming aster. You can see it's one of the few things. It's November 1st, and so this one's covered by pollinators. It's also unlike many of the more colorful asters, the New England and New York asters, which have much more vivid colors. These tend to be an off-white. Again, they bloom really, really late. Here's some more. And as such, they provide a last source of nectar, you know, for things like these metallic sweat bees that you see kind of coming on this one. They're very shade tolerant, which is unlike many asters except for the white wood aster, and they do like moist conditions. These are inside of a river. But a neat aster, very late blooming, tolerant of both most moist and shady conditions, and one of the last gasp nectar sources for many of our pollinators this late in the year. So blue wood asters, really neat plants, not always the most, you know, vivid blue, and these are already starting to fade as is, but a very neat woodland species that blooms so late in the fall, the blue wood aster. Here, attracting a lot of attention from pollinators, blue wood aster.